strikes me that it has no particular requirement, except maybe to say, frankly, George, that if anybody is leaving the social housing sector to escape bedroom tax by moving to the private rented sector, then they are finding themselves hit by, well, bedroom tax was introduced by Gordon Brown. Mm-hmm. That's the fact they're looking for bedroom for bedroom similar types of pubs, because the facts of the matter. I think we could have a reasonable debate about housing tax. I took this one to be commentary on the private rented sector. That's why I was hoping to just limit my remarks to that. George, I think you've expanded it into the social sector, which I don't see this this one should affect at all. I will, in conclusion, I think, congratulate Ian Lewis, who has scoured the Queen's speech for good news. In order to put something before us, as his department, it is, you know, it's often said that a clock is right at least twice a day. At least you found one occasion where the rules have got something. And it's been a long time. The House of Lords has considered this sort of legislation during the last Parliament. Our ministers at that point refused to go quite this far and instead insisted that the tenancy fees were advertised clearly on websites. I'm not even sure that some of these letting agents are doing that. You've got to click, you've got to send something to find what tenancy fees are. So I am pleased that finally, after, you know, cross-party cabinets, you know, House of Lords, etc., the tenancy fees in the private rented sector look as though they will no longer apply. I'll come back to the issue so far as the gentleman can say, maybe when we have the debate on the gentleman.
Thank you.
Any other contributions? I'm going to move to seconders otherwise.
Okay, Councillor Adrian Jones, seconder of the Labour
amendment, now 3 minutes. Thank you, Madam Mayor. I'll keep it short. First, Madam Mayor, may I welcome this improbable initiative from the Conservatives, Councillor Lewis. And if Ian continues to get as radical and left wing as this in his approach, he's really close to having just been called Comrade Lewis by members of his own party. We're not going to oppose this very mild improvement that will, in any case, I understand, be enshrined in legislation. So, in fact, Madam Mayor, if you can just go back a little bit to the previous occasion,
fines fees, and some even charge a non-holding £4.3 million in England alone. Now, there is a legitimate cost to landlords and national letting agencies, but the fees do differ considerably and can run into hundreds of pounds. And this is unfair on tenants that often have little control over these fees, as it's chosen by the landlord, the letting agents are chosen by the landlord. And it's often difficult for tenants to compare the different charges from letting agents, as there is a huge variation the way charges are described and what they actually charge for. By banning the letting agents' fee, it will strengthen the position of private landlords, and so they'll have a clear offer from letting agents and what they will charge from the services they offer. The benefit to tenants will be that they won't be confused by the various descriptions of all those fees, and a big clear size price of what certain properties cost to enable them to move around the private rented sector. Madam Mayor, I would urge all councils actually to back this motion. It is on the private sector. It will reduce the cost of renting properties for the tenants and give landlords a clear direction of what value for money they are getting with letting agents. I mean, Wirral can be ahead of the curve on this by ensuring that changes to information, advice and guidance are ready in time for when the legislation is introduced. Thank you, Madam Mayor.
Thank you,
Councillor Anderson.
Can I thank Councillor Jones for his comments? They're taken with good humour, as always. I'm not quite sure if he wants me to call him comrade, or he's hoping I'll call him comrade. I would advise not to hold his breath. Or maybe do hold your breath, David. The substantive motive that the motion we put forward simply applies to private sector rented properties. It doesn't apply to the social landlords that we have in the borough. It doesn't apply to owner-occupiers, clearly. It's purely about the private rented sector, that's all. If we wanted to bring in ideology, as Councillor Burns has referred to, we would have mentioned the fact that the current government, since 2010, has built more new council homes than the previous Labour government. But we left that out, because we didn't want to make it political. So, Madam Mayor, I would urge the Council to support the notice of motion as proposed, unamended, and that we help those in need in this borough as soon as the law is created by the strong and stable government that is now.
Thank you.
Okay, colleagues, can we come to order, please? Thank you. I think everybody who is coming back in is now back in the chamber. We're now going to move to the motion loss of social housing to ban on letting Zella LP. Can I have move and second again, please? Thank you. Right, Councillor Kelly, you now have up to 5 minutes to move to the motion.
I'm under pressure, I feel, Madam Mayor, that last debate, Council Lewis managed to get unanimity in the Council Chamber on a housing issue, and now I feel under pressure to do exactly the same thing. Let's have a go. Madam Mayor, the promotion itself is actually fairly self explanatory, and the issue raises, I think, a straightforward matter of principle. Should any of the existing social housing stock be farmed out to a lesser company for private rents? That's the question. When we talk about rural social housing stock, we're really talking about houses in the ownership of Magenta Living, formerly Wirral Partnership Homes, set up around 2003 to receive Wirral's own form of council housing. So there's definite line of sight here. The council should take an interest in what becomes of its former council houses. Magenta have taken the decision to remove, over a period of years, 100 houses intended for social housing and our management via a new company called Bamboo Lettings. Bamboo Lettings is a partnership between the Magenta and a St Helens-based company called Towers Housing. Magenta is offering, through this new company, Bamboo Lettings, houses intended to be social housing for private rent. And they're doing this at a time when there are over 9,000 people on the social housing waiting list. A few weeks ago, Madam Mayor, I was phoned by a constituent concerned that a house that they saw was vacant and for let was not available to them via the choice-based letting system, and that instead she was directed by Magenta to rentmove.com if she wanted to rent the house. If she wanted to rent the house, it would cost her, of course, £40 more per week. But further, she would have to pay the iniquitous private letting fees. This is the subject that the Hillers have been able to get unanimity on. We are all opposed to the concept of private letting fees. I've laid out the charges that appear on their website, on the whitemove.com website, for the charges that are applicable. Even the government have conceded that the fees are unfair, and I think it would be unfair given the votes of the previous debate, if the council now took the view that it's okay for Magenta, stroke bamboo, to levy these charges in respect of former council houses. Now, I do have some sympathy for Magenta's position, their finances are because tight, and they are looking to generate some income, but I don't believe that this is the right way forward. The profits for this, particularly post-ending of the letting fees, is not likely, in my view, to raise sufficient funds in the year to construct a single additional house. Magenta have also said they're looking at building houses for sale, with the profits from that activity put back into building more social houses. That strikes me as an eminently more sensible way forward, adding stock to the market rather than taking the stock away, and it's more likely to generate the kind of money that they will need to build new houses. Many of us have argued, and Councillor Davis referred to this in the previous debate, respect of the right to buy policy for council houses, that the single fatal flaw in that was always the councils are actively prevented from reinvesting sale receipts into building a replacement stock. I'll stop there, Madam Mayor, with one final thought. It is easy to look at this as a balance sheet exercise, profits and loss, the value of bricks and mortar as assets to be exploited, and the value maximised. However, we mustn't lose sight that it's the people who will lose out due to this policy are families seeking a very house, social houses, that Magenta has moved effectively into the private rented sector. Every home advertised on whitemove.com by Bamboo is lost to those families seeking social housing. I'd say, Madam Mayor, this is a civil matter of principle. I will move the motion and I look forward to addressing any issues that are raised during the course of the debate.
Thank you, Councillor Kelly.
Anybody
want to move to the motion?
I was a little confused. What is a good thing? What is a bad thing? And I couldn't quite get the balance right. But at the end of the day, the balance is right. And we just listened to the debate on tenancy fees, and George talked about the right to buy, and then that took houses out of social housing. I see no difference. This is taking houses out of social housing into private landlords. And while there's only 100 at the moment, with N, is it another 200?